In this short video of SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard, we're going to look at handling legacy data. When we're handling legacy data and bringing this over into PDM Standard, we need to consider the library components that are already stored in PDM. How do we want to handle duplicate files if the component already exists in my library components and we have this in our data set that we're bringing over? And what can we then do to update references inside of PDM without the need for opening the files inside of SOLIDWORKS, browsing to the file it should be using to update the references before we then check that assembly into PDM? Inside of my PDM vault, I have a standard parts folder. And in there, I've already brought across some standard components that I use on a regular basis. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to bring across a legacy design, and I'm going to bring that across just by simply copying and pasting this into PDM. Once I copy and paste this into PDM, PDM is going to detect any duplicates that are in my dataset that I'm bringing across. We can see the lead screw component that it's trying to add here already exists in my standard parts folder. So how we can correct this then is, first of all, we just simply delete this duplicate. We don't want to allow duplicates of this component in PDM. What I then need to do is update this assembly in PDM to tell it to use the lead screw in my standard library components folder. So rather than open it in SOLIDWORKS and update the reference, I can simply go to the Tools menu, Update References, and it will then inform me which component or components it can't find. I can then tell SOLIDWORKS PDM which folder I want to search for these missing files, and it will then analyze this folder and pick up that the lead screw component is in this folder. Once I've finished this, I can then update the references, and PDM will then update the references within this assembly to use the lead screw from the standard parts folder. If I now go ahead and check this assembly in, it doesn't need to check the lead screw component in because it's picked up that it already exists in the standard parts folder. I can then go ahead and check this assembly into PDM. And if we then look at the contains tab, we can see that our lead screw is being pulled from the standard parts folder, and also several toolbox components are being pulled from the toolbox folder. So with SOLIDWORKS PDM, it allows us to bring across legacy designs, update the references with relative ease where we don't want to allow duplicates in PDM, and we have a folder which stores our standard library components and toolbox components as well. Thank you.